Good morning students, I am Ma'am Violet Bailey and today in science we will be studying the next chapter of your book. The name of the chapter is Our Body Systems. We will cover half of the chapter in this video and rest we will cover in the next video. In this video today I will be teaching you about cells, what are cells, and then there are total 8 organ systems in our body, but we will cover only 3 organ systems today, and those organ systems are the skeletal system, the muscular system, and the nervous system. And we will also learn about the sense organs. So students, let us now start the chapter. You all must have seen a building. How is the building made? It is made up of bricks. So, in the same way, a body is made up of cells. Cells are the building blocks of our body. These cells join together to form complex organs and organ systems. Let us now understand what are cells. All the organisms are made of cells. Cells are the smallest functional unit of our body. This means that cells are the smallest independent component which provides structure to the body and convert the nutrients taken from the food into energy. Now let us understand what is a tissue. Many cells join together to form a tissue. This means that tissue is a group of cells that are same in structure and they are joined together to perform a specific work. Let us now understand what is an organ. Many tissues join together to form an organ. The example of an organ is kidney. This means that organ is a group of tissues which perform a specific function. Let us now understand what is an organ system. Many organs join together to form an organ system. Here you can see an example of excretory system. This means that group of organs work together or join together to perform a specific work. Like here, you can see that different organs are involved here and they make up excretory system and they perform one function, that is excretion. Let us now understand what is an organism. Number of organ systems join together and function together to form an organism. Here you can see the example of human being. This means that there are many organ systems in an organism. All these organ systems work together efficiently in collaboration with each other. They work together, they function together, and they make up one single organism. Let us quickly revise the level of organizations in our body. The smallest unit in our body is cell. Group of cells make up tissue. Group of tissues make up an organ. Group of organs make up organ system. And group of organ systems make up an organism. Let us know what are microorganisms. There are many small organisms that are made up of only one cell. They are known as microorganisms. Some of the examples of microorganisms are bacteria, amoeba, protozoa, etc. Let us now learn about different organ systems in our body. When few organs together carry out one major function for the body, they form an organ system. The different organ systems help a body to function properly. If we take up the example of breathing, then the organs that are involved in breathing are your nose, your windpipe, lungs. So all these organs work together to carry out one function, that is breathing, and all these organs together make up the respiratory system. Like that, we have 8 important organ systems in our body. Let us now learn one by one all these organ systems. First, we will learn about skeletal system. The skeletal system comprises of a bony framework. That means it is made up of bones. It gives shapes and support to our body. There are 206 bones in our body. When joined together, they form the united framework called skeleton. Next organ system is muscular system. Muscular system comprises of muscles. Muscles are attached to the bones. Muscles help in body movement. That means it helps our body to move. There are more than 500 muscles in our body. Next organ system is nervous system. Nervous system is made up of the brain, the spinal cord, and the nerves. This system helps us to think, reason, and act accordingly. Let us now know how sense organs help us. You all know that we have 5 sense organs: eyes, ear, nose, tongue, and skin. These sense organs receives information and convey it to the brain. These sense organs are connected to the brain through a network of nerves. So this means that whatever we feel through our sense organs, whatever we see, we hear, we taste, we receive from our sense organs, and that information is transferred to the brain through the nerves. I hope, students, you have understood whatever has been taught to you today regarding cells, tissues, organs, organ systems, level of organization, then your skeletal system, muscular system, nervous system, and sense organs. The rest of the chapter will be covered in the next video. Today, I will be giving you some assignments that you have to do and understand. Watch the video again and again and complete the assignment as per the instructions given to you.